The trickiest part of this problem is setting it up. We need to figure out the correct placement of the values on the left-hand side of the butterfly network. Even though as we go forward here, omega is going to be negative I instead of I, because we're doing the inverse transform, we need to order the values according to the omega that was used in the forward transform. So thus, omega to the 1 is I, and omega to the 3rd power is negative I here. Carrying the calculation forward a level, we obtain these results here. Then for this last level, we have 4 plus 8, which is 12. Good. Then for this next one, we want omega to the 1st power times this. And because we're doing the inverse transform, that omega is negative I. And that gives us this result here of 4. For the next one, we multiply the odd term by negative 1. So that gives us negative 4 here. And for the last one, we multiply by our omega cubed, which is I. We multiply that by the odd term. And combining that with this gives us a total of 8. To get the original polynomial, we divide by n, 4 in this case. Thus we have that the original polynomial was 3 plus x minus x squared plus 2x cubed. And you can check that that all works out. Note that there is a sense in which the ordering over here was arbitrary. We could have done the forward transform with omega equal to negative I, in which case I would have flipped these, and then the inverse transform would have used I here and negative I here. And that would have given us the same result.